I'll show some of the equipment what is needed for raising these chicks. This is one feeder. Now here for this 40 day old chicks, we start introducing this paddy and then this millet. And then in this container, we can add the food from the top there. And then it lets out in the smaller quantities so that there is no wastage. Now in the whole grains, if the grains fall out, it doesn't waste because they eat it up later. If it rains, they like the sprouts also. And for water, we have kept these tubs. This one for fresh water. And then I'll also show the coop now. For the fencing, we have got this metal mesh. This one, there are various grades, you can select whatever is the best available. And for the roofing, we have used this fishing net, the old fishing net with holes and all, which you can get almost free if you look around. And then the fence support is, we have salvaged old pieces of some piping, some bamboo and all, and made the support for the hedge, for the fence. And so around like this, yeah. Come down also, huh? See, so all round this fence is there, and then the fishing net on top. And for water, we have these those tubs. And inside the coop, I'll show you now. Going. Now this is a batch what I'm showing is 45 days old. About 45 days old. This coop is a nice coop. It works very well. It has some windows. 2-3 small windows we've covered because it's cold now. But in the summer it can be open for cross ventilation. And then these bulbs for warmth. You need 200 candle bulbs in the night to keep them warm when they're very young. And for the flooring, this paddy husk serves very well. If you clean regularly, there will be no smell or anything. And it's dry and it's warm for their feet in the winter and all. It's very nice. And it's quite cheap. You can even get free sometimes. And then spread it on the floor. It lasts for a week. And then it's mopped up and put in a compost pit. And the door is kept open in the daytime so that if they are cold, they can go in. If they want to sun themselves, they come out. And once they are about 2 months old, then they can be let into the big open area. Now this one is a small enclosed area because they are still in the young stage. This Swarnadhara breed is like Giriraja, but they say it has lays more eggs, some 25 eggs more, and it's little lighter weight, and it's more specialized for the egg laying rather than the meat. So the door of the coop is also, we salvaged some wooden mesh, welded it together like this. And this roof also, we used some salvaged asbestos, whatever, zinc sheets. So if you use a lot of this waste materials, if you look around and gather, you can save money on the door, the frame, the window, and then even the bricks. Some old bricks can do because the structure is not very heavy. There are a number of ways to minimize the cost of the whole enterprise. And this is good enough to raise batches of 200 chicks at a time. For 2 months they can be kept in this enclosure, and third month they can go out and you can get the next batch in. So
So in a year, about almost 6 batches can be raised. That is 1,200 birds a person can raise if they have one coop like this.